you know, a lot more emotions go through my body when I'm bowling, because I feel like I have to stay a bit more calm when I'm batting. But I'm trying to take a wicket every ball. I always try and do that. And you know, I can leak a few runs, but you know, I'm more than happy to do that if I'm trying to take a wicket every ball. And you know, just trying to back up Jimmy and Brodie's hard work at the top. When I get hit for four, you know, I'm as annoyed as anyone else in the ground is watching. But now I can sort of forget about that when I'm at the end of my mark now, and put that in the past and then just concentrate on the next ball. But that's what sort of gets my juices flowing, and I think that's what makes me, you know, well, that's how I want to play my cricket. I always want to be, you know, that aggressive and looking like I'm putting all the effort in, because I certainly am. It's always brilliant taking wickets, especially in a test match, because the whole crowd just erupts. And then you've got the other 10 guys who literally just crowd around you and, you know, hugging you, slapping you on your back, slapping you on the top of your head. So for that 5-10 seconds, you know, I don't think any bowler or any person could explain the feeling of what goes on then. It's just one of them special feelings you only get from cricket, I guess. After our first bowling session in Cardiff, I hadn't played since the 2020 at Old Trafford. I remember waking up the next morning thinking, oh, I can't remember the last time I felt like this. It sort of reminded me of how much, you know, pressure goes on your body from playing cricket, and you know, but now, you know, we've got a long run in cricket, test matches, and then through the one days, and then the 2020s as well, then hopefully I'll never feel as stiff as I did waking up from that third morning. I mean, cricket's only a short game, career-wise. You know, you start at 20, you end at 35, 36, so to be able to stay in the park for as long as we want to, you know, we have to do all our gym work, fitness, prehab, stretching, making sure we're still strong, making sure we're still fit. So there's a lot of work that goes in behind closed doors to make sure that, you know, we don't break down, and hopefully our careers go as long as we want to, because unfortunately we realistically can't play until we're 45. So we've got to get the best out of our bodies, I guess, for as long as we can.